Now, I will say this. This is what I believe they should have did with Black Adam. I definitely believe that they should have took their time with Black Adam. The first hour of the movie should have been a slow burn. Period. It should have been him going through all types of stuff and led up to this. All right, man. Told you to talk. Like, share, subscribe to the page. Hit the thumbs up button if you like the king. So, this is going to be my Black Adam spoiler-filled review. So, if you don't want to be spoiled or whatever, then listen to me. So, I'm not going to be one of those people that's going to go frame by frame and detail by detail and move all through the movie. I'm just going to tell you how I feel. And if this spoiler part come up, then that's what it is. So, let's get to it. All right, so... So Black Adam for me, it was an okay movie. It was okay. I think that Dwayne making his debut as Black Adam, I think he did a really good job as Black Adam. I think that he put himself in a position where he's a force to be reckoned with in the DC universe. And that's how it's supposed to be with Black Adam, because that's how it is. As far as the acting goes, I really didn't take too much from the acting. I think that the acting was just an acting. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't really dig so deep into it, because I didn't go into it with these high expectations. Like I said in my other video, I didn't go into it with these high expectations that this was going to be something groundbreaking. I just thought it was going to be a good popcorn flick, you know, something that you could take your girlfriend to, you know, have a good time, you know, get a couple of nachos in you. So, so the acting was okay. I would say the acting was okay. It was only one part that I really didn't like, and that was the little boy. I could not stand the little boy. My thing is like it. I understand that you have to bring a good element for family to make people, you know, relate and some people want to watch. But when you got a little annoying kid in the movie, it's like the series strain. I just hate these kids who just feel like they know everything more than anybody else, and they're so entitled to everything. And it's like, what? You're telling me, like, and it's just like, I understand this is a comic book movie. Don't get me wrong. And I'm not really going to go too deep into nitpicking, but I'm just going to say, I understand it's a comic book movie. But certain things, it has to be kind of rooted in reality a little bit. But when you got a little boy who is dipping and dodging the inner game, like, get the fuck out of here. No, I'm not rolling with that. So he was the most annoying part of the movie. The second annoying part of the movie was Adam Smasher. Excuse me. Adam Smasher. Adam Smasher didn't bring nothing to it. Him and Cyclone didn't bring anything to the table. For me, that was actually significant that I would say that, yeah, they brought something to the table and he made the movie fire. The girl that played Cyclone, she was a nice looking woman. And I think that, you know, she really didn't do anything that was, to me, that anything of any substance. It's like, what was you doing? So I just thought that they could have did better with those two. Maybe they could have had a little more serious role, but Black Adam played between, it's a good dynamic with this movie, actually. They played between him being so super serious to, you know, the teenage like characters. Then you had Hawkman, which was fire. I liked Hawkman. I liked the fact that Hawkman was basically about justice. Like, yeah, nah, this is what it is. This is what it is. You ain't going to do none of this. You won't stop. You can't kill people. We superheroes. You can't do that. And it's no matter how much Black Adam told this fool that he's not a hero, then you should have known that. Well, I see the good in you. No, 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 no. And the best part of the movie was Dr. Fate. Dr. Fate was the best part of the movie. Even more than The Rock. I'm sorry. I thought Pierce Brosnan was phenomenal as Dr. Fate. I don't understand how Sabat beat Dr. Fee. That's not happening. No. That's not happening. Not in the comic books. Maybe they needed something for that. I honestly think that he should have killed Atom Smasher. That's what I think she should have killed. I think he should have killed Atom Smasher because Atom Smasher wasn't listening. And he did something. That's what I believe. But that didn't happen. They end up killing Dr. Fate. Which was stupid. Like, he was the best, one of the best parts of the movie. Overall, The Rock did a great job. I think the villain of the movie was kind of weak. I don't think that he was, like, a really good villain. I think he's very forgettable, and I think people are going to be like, oh, well, whatever. But I think that him in the Rock fight was, it's pretty cool. Now, as far as the special effects in this, this is top-notch. This is, like, maybe top five best special effects comic book movie stuff here. Like, this is on par with Zack Snyder's Justice League. It's on par with that. It's like up there. I think it's a couple of movies that come to mind when it comes to this stuff, but I clearly would say Justice League and Infinity War, the first one. You know what I mean? Not Endgame. Endgame was okay, but far special effects go, I think Infinity War is like top notch. And I put Zack Snyder's Justice League, like, they like neck and neck to me. But I think that the special effects they did, he put a lot of money into, did a good job. Man, Dr. Fate looks amazing, man. I would go see it just to see the special effects again because it was amazing. Now I gave this movie a 7 out of 10. I think that it's a couple of things that I didn't like, but overall, I enjoyed the movie. I enjoyed it more than the things I didn't like. And the things I didn't like is just really nitpicks. You know what I'm saying? Like, the little boy, he's a nitpick. It ain't something that would ruin the movie for me, because it didn't ruin it. Now, I will say this. This is what I believe they should have did with Black Adam. I definitely believe that they should have took their time with Black Adam. The first hour of the movie should have been a slow burn, period. It should have been him going through all types of stuff and led up to this. I think the second half should have been more about the JSA and how they come into play with this. Not just the not an origin story of the JSA, but a little more in depth detail of how did they get to this point. And then I think they should have fought Black Adam. And as they're fighting Black Adam, this guy comes out of nowhere. Because basically he's from Black Adam's past. And I guess he's coming to seek revenge or whatever you want to do. He's coming back and he's destroying stuff, and then Black Adam kind of like has to team up with the JSA. That's what I believe should happen. This dude, the dude, the enemy, the bad guy, whoever you want to call him, he should have been so overpowering that it took all of them to defeat him. I think that they missed. This wasn't really an origin story. It didn't feel like an origin story. This felt like something that they just put together real quick and put it out with some good special effects, and it was a pretty good movie. I think that it could have been a classic if they would have took their time with the storyline. You know what I'm saying? Like, really took their time. Limit the action maybe towards the second half, and that's what called for. Like, or the first 45 minutes to it should have been just about him, his family, and how he got to that point. I just don't believe that they did that enough. They just kind of touched on it a little bit, and it's like, I really couldn't feel connected to the character, Black Adam, because of that. But that's what I believe. I believe that It should have been that. Or he shouldn't introduce the JSA at all. He should have just basically had an origin story about Black Adam. And he should have made it like it was a mythical, he's a mythical guy. And then towards the end, you know, he's destroying stuff. And then towards the end, the JSA comes in. And then the second movie, you go into the JSA, how they form, and then they meet up with Black Adam. That's what I believe. Because I believe that these movies, to me, if you read the comic books, they're much more deeper than the movie. And I understand you got to compact the movie in altogether. You know what I'm saying? I understand that. But I do believe that these movies, these comic book movies, could be so much better than what they are. You know what I'm saying? That's why I think Zack Snyder's Justice League is like top of the line. You know what I'm saying? Top of the line. Even like when Infinity Wars was more like, it wasn't even comic book accurate, but it was pretty good. I just think that was a little more, it's a little different. I don't want to get into that. But anyway, so that's what I believe that, as far as Black Adam goes. I think that the next movie, it definitely got to touch on, you know, I guess now it's too late, but this is a deeper storyline. Now, end credit scene. And I want to talk about this because I think this is important. End credit scene, Henry Cavill comes back. Now, does Henry Cavill come back? Is this post Zack Snyder? Or is this after Zack Snyder? That's the question I have. I'm thinking that this happens after the events of Justice League. That's what I'm believing. But here's the thing, and I think that this is the missed opportunity that I think that Warner Brothers is. Now, again, I'm totally on board with restoring the Snyderverse. On board. I think that Black Adam should fight Superman. Superman wins. Right? Or Black Adam wins. Whoever wins. Again, it goes back to the major threat that's coming to the planet. Now, if this is after the events of Zack Snyder's Justice League, then it doesn't make any sense. But if this is before, then they recruit him to help fight Darkseid. Because it is what it is. Now, I don't know how The Rock fits into the timeline on this, and this is what makes me believe that this is the events. These events are happening after Justice League 2 and Justice League 3 and all that stuff, because Henry Cavill got the curl in his head. This is like, he's a different Superman, even though was casted by Zack. I think that somehow they should fit The Rock into the storyline, kind of like how they did, and I hate the comparison, but it is what it is, kind of like how they did Ms. Marvel. Like kind of how they did that. So I think they definitely should put him in it. Now, what I want to see is, I want to see Black Adam, Justice League, and Justice Society fight Darkseid. That's what everybody wants to see. That would be nuts. But we got to build up to it. So we'll see what happens. But again, 7 out of 10. 7 out of 10. I think that, to me, storyline could have been better. But that's about it. There's a little bit of nitpicks here and there. But other than that, certain things that I think really worked, certain things I think didn't work. But again, hey, Torture Talk. You know what it is. Like, share, subscribe. Let me know what you believe or what you think in the comments about the movie. Do you think that they should have killed off Dr. Fate? Do you think that Dr. Fate is going to come back? Do you think that they should make a Justice League 2 and have Black Adam in it when they fight Darkseid? What do you think? Like, share, subscribe.